Coming up, we'll take a look at updates to Yammer for Enterprise Social, from enhanced security and compliance and greater team productivity to new integrated experience with Office 365, including Office Video and Dell. And we'll even take a look at new admin controls for analytics, merging networks, and managing users. Joined today by Angus Florance from the Yammer team. Welcome. So if you're new to Yammer, it provides a private enterprise social network for your organization. Now you might be thinking, it's been a few months before you've heard anything from the Yammer team, but there's been a lot going on that's new here, right?
Absolutely. So since we've become part of the Office 365 family, adoption of Yammer is growing faster than ever. And we've spent a lot of time recently really integrating Yammer into the back end of Office 365 to really try and leverage some of those security and compliance features and make it an enterprise-grade tool.
And I know that we're actually running all of those Yammer services in the same data centers that we run Office 365 and Azure.
That's right. So Yammer now meets the same security and compliance standards as the rest of the Office 365 suite. What this also means is directionally, we can now integrate Yammer into where we think it makes the most sense to have conversations across your organization. So the most recent example of that is with Skype Meeting Broadcast, where you can attach a Yammer group and have a real-time conversation while someone's broadcasting a meeting live.
But on the flip side of that, if you maybe have one or two people working on an individual file, a Word doc, that's something that you would manage via Skype for Business messaging. So beyond this, one of the things that's pretty exciting is that we've turned Yammer on by default in Office 365 Tenants.
That's right. So Yammer now works like any other workload inside Office 365. Because we have a single identity, we can log into yammer.com, it will recognize my Office 365 identity and pass me through.
So this is on Edge browser. So because you're signed in with an Azure AD account on this computer, it lets you log straight in.
Straight in. And because I have that, again, that single account, I can seamlessly switch between the different workloads without having to log in and out like we used to.
So this is really great in terms of deeper integration with Azure AD and really the backbone of Office 365 and Azure. But beyond that, what are some of the new experiences that we've built in Yammer?
So we've really been focusing hard on improving the way people have conversations in Yammer, but also really focusing on helping people get work done inside the tool. And with that, we've done some work around how groups work and really trying to improve the group experience in Yammer.
Okay.
So if we come into a group, you'll see here that now all groups have their own color custom header and logo. And this is, again, consistent across whether it's a mobile app or website to give that real sense of purpose and clarity so people know what they're trying to do inside this group.
And this looks new here, the Unread Conversations with a counter next to it.
Yeah, so again, it's important when you think about trying to get work done, you want to make sure you only see unread messages. You don't want to trawl through stuff that's been there for a long time. And so when you first land in a group, we're only going to show your unread conversations since the last time you're in here. And as I scroll through, you'll notice that that counter drops down as I read through these messages, and I can like and reply and share these. When I get to the bottom of the group and I've read all these messages, it then prompts me to go to my next group that has unread messages inside it.
And something else I've seen recently with Yammer is notifications popping up as I make updates or other people make updates in the feeds that I'm part of.
Absolutely. So let's show that now. So if you're in a Yammer group and you post a message and I just happen to be in Yammer at the same time, I'll get a little notification in my navigation bar with your profile picture, and the unread group count will go up, and then I can click on that message and go in and edit it.
Very cool. So that's on the PC and in the browser, but we've also done a bunch in terms of the mobile experience. So can you give us a look at that?
We've added a lot of features to our iOS and Android apps to really try and get them up to par with our web. They should be standalone applications. Mm-hmm. We've also incorporated a lot of the same features around groups. So you can see here, when I open up the app, I'm showing my most recent groups and, again, any unread messages within those groups.
Okay.
So I can click on a group with unread messages. Again, you get the standard group header and logo, and I can scroll through this and like, reply messages as I need to.
So a very cohesive group experience, but I know even in the inbox, you've made some changes there as well, right?
Yeah, so the Yammer inbox is really where we keep all your priority messages across the network. So every conversation that you've been a part of, whether no matter what group it's in, will live inside your inbox. Mm-hmm. And so we've improved that experience both on mobile and the web. So when you come in, again, you're only greeted with your unread messages across your inbox, so you can come through and see which ones are most important. If you wanted to mark one as read, you can swipe to the left. If you no longer want to follow a conversation, you can swipe to the right and that will drop it out of your inbox. Or if obviously you want to view them all, you can click on that and see all messages. And again, we've mirrored this experience in the web app as well.
Very cool. So I can stay productive on the go, whether I'm on my phone or my PC. But beyond this, we've done a bunch of work around external collaboration, right?
Absolutely. So when we think about teams collaborating, we know today that Teammates can be outside your organization, whether they're customers, partners, suppliers. And so very recently we launched this concept of a Yammer external group. And they work in a very similar way to existing Yammer groups, except when you create the group, you make it external, and then you can add people's external to your organization email address, and then they'll get invited to that group to work on. So if I come in to an existing group, you'll see here we've actually separated out groups, external groups or internal groups, so people know that they're in a different context. Mm-hmm. And when you're inside the group itself, you'll see things like the companies in the group header, the companies that are part of the group, but also when you click on that, you can see the people by company who's also participating in that group. Other things we've done is highlight through the thread itself, so a globe will show you that there's external people present inside the conversation. And when I click reply, I can actually warn that, hey, there's other people outside of your network who are going to see this. And if I want to see who that is, I can click on that and it will give me a list of people who will see this message.
Very cool. So that's a ton of really new, great improvements in Yammer. And this gets even more powerful with the integration of Yammer conversations across Office 365.
Yeah. So what are the key integration points? One of the first ones we wanted to do was around files, because we know when people want to get work done, they don't just talk about work. They obviously use Word, PowerPoint, Excel,
right,
those type of files. And so what we've done is leverage the strength of Office 365 in their Office web apps. So when you open one of those types of files in Yammer, it actually renders that file directly within the Yammer interface.
So this is really cool because actually it's using Office Online here. So I can do things like co-author, check version history, edit the file right from within Yammer.
Exactly. So we can click edit file here and you and I can co-author that document. But one of the real advantages, because this file's in Yammer, we also get all the social features that come with it as well. And so we get things like being able to share the file, you can follow it so you always get notified of updates. We can mark files as official so they're locked and read-only so no one else can edit that file. I can obviously see version history and other people that are following the file. But what's most important in Yammer is being able to get the context of this content. So you can see at the bottom of the file, I can see any conversation that attached to that across the network.
So a lot of great integration, but I know that we've done even more than just these things. So what else is new?
Absolutely. So what we've also done is take the conversation out of Yammer and embed it across different parts of the suite.
Okay.
So things like Delve. If I'm in Delve and I'm scrolling through and looking at different parts of content, if I find a file in here that I think could be valuable to other people inside my organization, maybe they haven't seen it yet, I can click on the Yammer icon here and then start a conversation back in my Yammer network referencing this file. And it's a very similar experience to what we can also do in Office 365 video, where, again, if I'm watching video as part of training or onboarding, or again, there's just something in there that I think people would benefit from seeing. Mm-hmm. As I'm watching that video, I can come down and click on the Yammer comments and again, share this video into my Yammer network and really help make that content go viral.
So even more awesome integration, but what else is coming?
So there's two big integrations coming over the next few months. The first one is Yammer's going to integrate into Office 365 groups. And what that basically means is every single Yammer group that you're a part of will also get things like a shared calendar inside Outlook that you can create events with that team. Or maybe when you upload a file into Yammer, it's actually going to get stored in the group SharePoint document library. So you'll get all the advantages of having the files inside SharePoint. The second one we're doing is around Skype for Business integration. So what that will mean is if there's four or five of us having a conversation inside a Yammer group and we want to maybe elevate that conversation to real time, mm-hmm. we can click a button and that will either open up a video or just a real time chat that we can use in Skype for Business.
So awesome user experiences, but let's switch gears for a minute. Something near and dear to me, IT. So what's new from an IT pro perspective?
Yeah, so we've been doing a lot of work in the IT admin area, really trying to leverage a lot of the existing capabilities inside Office 365 and then applying them to Yammer depending on the situation.
Okay.
So an example of one of those that we've done is being able to migrate networks. So let's say, for example, your company has added an extra Yammer network via merge acquisition, or maybe you've opened a new branch. So with this new network migration tool, if those domains live inside Office 365, you can now automatically merge these two together into a single Yammer network for your company.
So there we have a UK domain and probably a US domain.
Absolutely, yeah.
So it even goes further than that, right? We can also do things like control who's using Yammer using some of the external and licensing controls, right?
Yeah, so earlier this year, we added the ability to enforce Office 365 identity. So that means if I'm a user of Yammer, but also a user of Office 365, as an IT pro, I can force people to use my Office 365 identity. Mm-hmm. And that gives you access to things like single sign-on, multi-factor authentication, all that good stuff as well.
Okay. How does that work?
So you can come in and you simply just tick this box. The other thing that this actually does, which is quite unique, is previously when Yammer was connected to an Office 365 tenant, it was just on for everybody. You couldn't control it at a per user level.
Right.
So now once we enforce Office 365 identity, we can now control this via licensing as well. So if I tick this box to say block users without a Yammer license and save that, if I then go back into the Office 365 admin portal and say, for example, Alex here, I can come down and turn Yammer off for him at a user level. And so that will make Yammer disappear from the launcher menu, and they won't be able to log in via yammer.com anymore.
Awesome. So lots of updates and a lot of things that we can do on the IT pro side as well as the user side. But can we do some other things in terms of seeing who's using Yammer?
Yeah, so earlier this year, the Office 365 team launched the reporting dashboard. And as part of that, Yammer was included.
Okay.
And so you can see here when you launch the dashboard, you get all your different workloads. And one of these is Yammer. So again, from a high level, you can see who's posted, how many people have posted, how many people have read and liked messages on your network. We can then drill into that and get that at a per user level. So by user, how many messages have they posted, read, and liked. The next thing we want to launch with this is group level analytics. So that's really around for each group in Yammer, how many members are there, how many messages have been posted, how many likes, that type of thing.
Great for tracking usage. So beyond this, if I'm an end user or maybe an IT pro, how do I start using Yammer right now?
If you're an Office 365 user today, it should be already on and you can get in there straight away. If you're IT pro and want to help launch Yammer across your network, we have lots and lots of resources on the Fast Track portal that'll help you get started and launch that inside your company.
So really a great set of updates. Thanks for giving us the tour today. Of course, keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for all the latest tech updates. Thanks everyone for watching and goodbye for now.